Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of CA Talks, a podcast for students by students. And today, we're going to be talking about our high school experience.
In fact, we won't be just talking, but also reacting.
Yeah, we'll be comparing these videos to our personal senior experience, and we'll give advice to upcoming seniors as to how to make the most of their senior year. So first, we're going to look at a clip from High School Musical. Coach said to fake right, get your head. Break left, watch out for the pick and keep an eye on the fence. Gotta run the give and go, take the ball to the hole. Don't be afraid, shoot the outside chair. You're really good.
Just keep your head in the game. Just keep your head in the game.
Don't be afraid, shoot the outside chair. Just keep your head in the game. No, actually, I'm sure girls basketball team is really good. But, you know they don't pay attention to the girls basketball team. Like, imagine you were like playing a game and some man starts like singing in the middle of the court.
That actually happened to me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Did he ever play basketball?
Yeah.
When?
Oh, no, I wasn't in the basketball. I was in the bleachers.
You were in the bleachers.
Have you ever seen High School Musical?
I only see like parts of it.
I always wanted to watch it, I still haven't had the time.
Alright, let's talk right there. Okay, just to give some context, this man is singing about how, so he got a basketball scholarship to go to this college, and in order to get the scholarship, he has to play basketball for all 4 years. But he's really into theater, and then he wants to pursue theater, right? So he ended up giving up this scholarship, which was a significant amount of money, and then his dad got really mad at him. And so his dad was saying that you should just do the basketball because they're giving you this money, and, you know, like, theater isn't really a priority. Which kind of isn't the right angle to go at, but I can kind of see where his dad is coming from because, you know, that is free money, and it's like you need a scholarship in order to, like, you know, fund your career, right? So our first tip would probably be like follow the money, especially for like your senior year. Even if you have like a dream or something like that, if you get a scholarship, you should keep it. Like nothing's stopping you from pursuing your interests outside of the scholarship. Mm-hmm. Like let's say you get like a STEM scholarship and you have to take a certain amount of classes in STEM. That doesn't mean that you can't take any humanities classes. That just means that your main focus in order to get your scholarship is to just get that STEM degree, mm-hmm. which is totally okay because you can, you know, if you go to one of these schools, you can, you know, enter clubs. You could like learn about this outside of your time. You can like meet with professors, take the classes you want to take, because as long as you meet the requirements, you're going to graduate, right? So I just found it really bizarre that this guy thought like either he had to do basketball or he had to do theater, when in reality he could have done both. And it was especially possible because, you know, he could have just majored in theater. Like nothing was stopping him from majoring in theater,
right? Like you have to remember, like, this goes to college too, but especially like this also works for high school. You know, make the most of your experience. Like you don't feel limited to do like one thing. Like, oh, I have to do basketball and I can't do theater, because those are like opposites. Like I don't think anyone believes that, but like you get the idea. It's like, don't feel so confined. If you want to do something, go for it. Don't be afraid. Okay, right now we're gonna go be looking at a clip of Mean Girls. It's a great movie, you should watch
new
it.
New movie just came out too, y'all should go watch it.
Oh, have you seen it?
No.
Okay.
So I have no idea, but I feel like you should go watch it just so you can tell me how it goes.
Right, okay.
You know, it's also really funny to me. They make the crushes so conventionally attractive, but they look grown. Like they're like 30 years old playing some like 16-year-olds. So you're like, when I got to like senior year, I realized that everyone looks very baby because we are.
That's because like it's easier to work with adults than minors.
I mean, there's also like child labor involved.
That's what I meant.
Oh no.
Okay, so you can see that Katie's a smart girl in this. Like, wow, she saw that calculus problem in no time. It took me a lot longer when I took calculus, but later on in
about
the...
when you took calculus.
Okay. later on when she, like later on in the movie, she's like trying to get his attention, right? So she's like, oh, can you help me with math homework? And he's like, you look like you got it down. So she purposely makes herself worse at math, and she ends up getting a bad grade in the class. So our next piece of advice is, like, it's kind of like a combo. So stay on top of your classes. Like, don't ever let like anything get in the way of like you trying to get your best grades possible. And like, you know, it's normal to have a crush, but like that's like not a good excuse to like do worse, right? So just make sure you're on top of that stuff. Like,
I mean, yeah, and you're in like high school too, and let's be so for real, relationships, just focus on graduating. Like, just focus on that. Especially since the entire movie, it just got her into like a lot more like
drama
and things like that, because this guy was like her friends but not really her friends, mm-hmm. like ex, and then it just like led to a whole lot of like other issues. So like, just don't get into any issues. Like, it's your last year, just enjoy it and stay on top of your classes. You want to finish strong, right? Don't be like Katie and try to fail your class and get a D in calculus all because you want some random guy to look at you. Mm-hmm. Because let's be so for real, he was kind of clueless the entire time. Like, he had no idea. So, you know, make sure that you just be yourself and be authentic. And, yeah, just enjoy your senior year.
Like, if a person, like, if you have to dumb yourself down for a person,
then that's kind of sad. don't do that.
And then, for your senior year, it's so important that you keep those strong grades because, you know, there have been applications that get rescinded. Like, you know, Katie was lucky that she was in her freshman year. What was it? Yeah, oh my God, brain fart. Yeah, your applications can get rescinded and you don't want that. So stay on top of your grades. Okay, we're gonna look at another clip of Mean Girls and let's just take it away.
Okay.
Contestants, find the limit of this equation.
Calling somebody else fat won't make you any skinnier. Calling someone stupid doesn't make you any smarter. And ruining Regina George's life definitely didn't make me any happier. All you can do in life is try to solve the problem in front of you.
I mean, I think she said it herself. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, the advice is all right there. Like, don't get so wrapped up in any, like, especially, like, this is good for, honestly, this is advice that's good for all high school. All of high school, oh my God. But especially for your senior year, like, just avoid the drama. Like, don't, you know, don't
be mean. Rest of your life, too, like, you know.
Actually, yeah. What am I saying? For your entire life, just avoid the drama. Don't, you know, think so hard about like how to ruin this other person's life or how to insult them or be the meanest person.
Yeah.
Like Katie says, just try to solve the problem in front of you. Like, you know, just don't, you know, let things escalate. I don't know, like, she really just said everything. Like, I feel like I'm just beating a dead horse.
I mean, you know, except for the fact that she's doing a calculus problem and she's in freshman year, I feel like I still can't get over that. Like, okay, she ate that, but like, you know, like, there's no point in trying to put, like, others down, because at the end of the day, it's going to reflect more poorly on you than the other person. And it's like, do you really got the energy to be, like, talking all the smack? Like, you don't. Like, just do what you need to do and just be a kind person. Like, it's because at the end of the day, like, that's what's going to bring you, like, more opportunities and more networking, because people are not going to want to hang with you if you're just a horrible person. All right, everyone. So that's about all the time we have today. Thank you for watching today's episode to watch High School Musical. So thank you for enjoying this episode of telling you how to enjoy your senior year, and we hope to see you again soon. Okay, bye.